Hello everyone, welcome back. I want to give all of you an update on how I'm doing on my Risdiplam journey. I have now passed my 2-month milestone and everything is going very well. And very, very excited that I have not had one single side effect. Except for the first week, you might remember, I had a little bit of gastro stuff going on for maybe a day, and that was it. So I am one of the very fortunate people on Risdiplam that has not experienced any of that ugly stuff, and I'm so grateful. I don't tolerate medicine very well usually, but it's really wonderful that Risdiplam is so easy to take. It is a liquid oral medication. It tastes like strawberry juice, literally like strawberry punch. It's actually delicious. You don't really taste the medicine in it, and that is a good thing because you don't mind taking the medication when it's like that, right? So that is one good thing. As I've been showing all of you the last 63 days now, I've had quite a bit of improvement. What I've noticed the most is my increase in stamina and endurance. And yes, I've seen an increase in my strength, although lifting my weights is not going as fast as I had hoped. I mean, I'm definitely able to curl more than 10 in one time with a 1-pound weight. The 2-pound weight is still very difficult for me. I still need to use two hands in order to lift it up. And then once I get it in my stronger arm, my right arm, I can hang on to it for quite a while and sort of go down and sort of lift up again, but it's difficult. I am very pleased that lifting the 1-pound weight in both my weaker left arm and my stronger right arm, I'm able to curl so many times without stopping. It's awesome. I'm able to lift it up. So it's very, 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 very exciting. I'll be going for my 6-month progress test very soon, in about 3 or 4 months. And they'll be determining at that point if Risdiplam is indeed working for me. And that will be measured by a pulmonary function test. So basically they will see if there's improvement in my respiratory, in my breathing, specifically in the amount of air volume that I can blow out. They will see if that has increased, and I certainly hope it has, because when I went for a test 4 months ago, I was quite discouraged because it was the lowest it's ever been in my life. And it's becoming dangerously low. And I'll let you know what I mean by that. For people with spinal muscular atrophy, like me, as the disorder progresses and our age does as well, a lot of people end up having to be ventilated during the day. I'm ventilated at night, but not during the day. And I'm trying really hard not to get to that point, which is why I am here in Quebec on Risdiplam. I certainly do not want to go down and end my life having to be ventilated all day long. It's not the worst thing in the world that could happen, but I mean, who wants to get that weak, right? All right, guys, enough negativity. I'm very excited. I have been showing a lot of fun things that we've been doing as well. Maybe a little bit more will be coming soon. And that is just to show you that, you know, there's a lot more to being on Risdiplam than just taking your medicine and exercising every day. As you gain strength and endurance and stamina, then you're able to go out more, you're able to do more like independently, away from home. And that's what I'm trying to show. So if you've enjoyed this video or any of my videos, please feel free to send me a comment or a like down below or subscribe to my channel. And I look forward to bringing you some more exciting content in the days that come. Thanks, everyone. Enjoy your day.